استنى 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 دنما Done, ma'am.
Completed, Lina? Done?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Lina, I have a class with you all only. Are you going to join the batch today, Lina? Do you have any information?
Ma'am, I can't hear you.
Am I audible now, Lina? Did you receive any reminder for today's class at 9 p.m.?
Yesterday 9.
Today, right now.
Let me just check.
Just check. If you have class with me right now, you can continue. Otherwise, you can leave, Lina. Okay.
Okay.
But just confirm it with the LearnEvio team once. Do you have a class right now or not?
Okay.
Yes, class. We had started with integration in the last class. Let's just wait for 2 minutes and then we'll start the class. Okay, class. So yes, we had seen in integration that whenever we have a polynomial function, it is starting from x to the power n and having limits x1 to x2, and then the limits are from d r till dx. Integrating it from x1 to x2 means the upper limit and the lower limit. Then when you integrate it, you get x to the power n is already there. It becomes n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So we write the 1 plus 1 term, which is a constant, separately, and then x2 to the power n plus 1 minus x1 to the power n plus 1. That is upper limit to the power the term minus lower limit to the power that term by n plus 1. Comes with some questions we had seen. These questions were left. Write it down. Try it first by yourself. Whoever gets the answer, chat column is open. Type me there. I'll discuss this. C class, let me discuss this part. This is x to the power 4. So this is our x to the power n. How do we write it? We add 1 to the power, right? And we divide it by the same. Fine. So what are we left with now? X to the power 5 divided by 5 from 0 to 1. This is how we write. Now, upper limit we'll substitute first. 1 to the power 5 minus lower limit then 0 to the power 5 divided by 5. This is equal to 1 divided by 5. Clear? This is how we'll write. So we'll get 1 by 5. This part also let me discuss so that you can write. This is only y. It means it is y to the power 1. So 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1 from 2 to. So this becomes y square divided by 2 from 2 to 4. Now what we'll do, upper limit first, that is 4 square minus lower limit then 2 square divided by 2. So 4 into 4 is 16 minus 2 into 2 is 4 divided by 2. This becomes 12 divided by 2, which is equal to 6. Write down both these parts, class. Okay, class, let us discuss this. This is x to the power 2. So plus 1 here divided by 2 plus 1 here, right? From 2 to 4. This is x to the power 3 divided by 3 from 2 to 4. Now, when we put the upper limit first, 4 cube minus then the lower limit, 2 cube divided by 3. So this is 4 cube, this is 64 minus 8 divided by 3. So this is 56 by 3. Now here we have t to the power 6 class. What we'll do, we'll add 1 here, divided by 6 plus 1. So this is from 0 to 1. This becomes t to the power 7 divided by 7 from 0 to 1. Then we'll put the upper limit first. 1 to the power 7 minus 0 to the power 7 divided by 7. This is equal to 1 by 7. Write it, class. Any doubts if you have, please ask me. Yes, class. Now let us discuss some other functions like the trigonometric one we have discussed in differentiation. So remember in differentiation when we had discussed the trigonometric function sine x integration, this is minus cos x. Remember when we were differentiating, so sine x gave you plus cos x. Remember, this is sine x is giving you minus cos x. So there is a difference, and please do not be confused with this. Remember one and make the other opposite for integration. Remember it for differentiation, you can just reverse it for integration. And likewise, you have cos theta, cos x, differentiation. So you get sine x. Now, how will you substitute it in integration? If you have done this, you have sine x and you have integrated it and you have written minus cos x, or you have written sine x. Now you have these two limits present. How will you substitute? So for sine x, suppose you will write sine x2 first minus sine x1. This is how you will write for the final and complete answer. Fine class. And for exponential, see, exponentials are same here also. The way exponentials were same when we were discussing the differentiation, we got e to the power x. But here, since we have limits, what we'll do? E to the power x2 minus e to the power x1. This is just one additional step that we have. If you have 1 by x and you are integrating it, you will get log x. Similarly, when you are integrating log x, you will get 1 by x. So log x2 minus log x1, this is how we'll write for the substitution of powers. Fine, we'll see some more properties, but write down these two first. See, when you are integrating a constant function, constant and a function. So what we'll do similarly, we'll isolate the constant term. See, this constant term has been isolated. And this is the rest of the function. Okay. So when we are writing this, see, 3 we'll write it separately, and we know how to integrate t squared dt from 0 to 2. At the last, we'll multiply. So see, t square is there. That is, this will become plus 1 divided by plus 1 from 0 to 2. But we have additional 3 here also. 3 into this is t cube divided by 3 from 0 to 2. Now look, class, this 3 and this 3, these are getting, both of these are getting cancelled. So when you put the upper limit, this is 2 cube minus 0 cube, which is just 2 cube, which is equal to 8. Write it, the next part you all will answer. It's clear? Adil, Ali, Nofil, is it clear till here? You all have not responded anything in today's class. Are you people understanding? All right, write it. C class, like this is a constant half. Now you know how to integrate t to the power 3 by 2 from 0 to 1. So what you will do? Plus 1 here divided by the same thing here. So this becomes 3 by 2 plus 1 is 5 by 2 divided by 5 by 2 from 0 to 1. So this is 2 by 5 if I write, if 2 goes up. And this becomes 1 by 5 by 2 minus 0 by 5 by 2. And we have this half also, right? This half is also there. So 2, 2 will be cancelled. 1 to the power 5 by 2 by 5 is equal to 1 by 5. Write it, class. Write down this question. And this question you all are going to tell me. 3 by t square from minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, Ali has got his answer also. So we can write this as 3t to the power minus 2, and then we can perform the integration. That is dt from minus 1 to plus 1. So t to the power minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1 from minus 1 to plus 1. So this becomes 3. 1 minus 2 is minus 1, and this is minus 1 from minus 1 to plus 1. This becomes minus 3, and this becomes 1 to the power minus 1 minus minus 1 to the power minus 1, right? Upper limit, then the lower limit. Let's do one thing. Let's bring this in the numerator, denominator, to make it positive. So this becomes 1 by 1 minus. Minus 1 by 1, when it will go in the denominator, minus 3 t to the power minus 1. T won't come. T have we have substituted already. T is substituted already, so t won't come. This is minus 1, when it will go in the denominator, so it will become this sign would be positive. So this, and this minus minus is plus. So we have minus 3 into 2, which is minus 6. We have reciprocated so that these powers are positive. So 1 and minus minus became plus. So we have minus 6. This year we have three only, and we are left with just dt from 0 to t. So whenever you have integration of dt, integration of dy, these individual quantities are left on integration. So dt is just t, all right, from 0 to 2, that is power is 1. So this becomes 2 to the power 1 minus 0 to the power. So 3 into 2 is equal to 6. Write it. Then we'll come to addition and subtraction. This is almost over. We'll come. For the individual addition and subtraction, same thing. You know how to individually integrate it. So just put the operations at the last. All right, you'll put the operations at the last. So individually, you know how to add it and subtract. This is the last topic for today. First, write it till here. I'll discuss then this. First, write it till here. Okay, last question. Let me discuss it. See, in such cases, no, you will multiply dt with these first, like t square dt, integrating it from 0 to 1, plus t dt, integrating it from 0 to 1, like this. So this will become t cubed by 3 from 0 to 1, plus this will become t square by 2 from 0 to 1. Now you will substitute the powers. This becomes 3 cube minus 0 cube. No, sorry, 1 cube. Upper limit is 1. So this will become 1. Divided by 3 plus this becomes 1 square minus 0 square by 2. So this becomes 1 by 3 plus 1 by 2. So this will be 5 by 6. Fine. So I hope integration is clear, differentiation is clear. From tomorrow, I'll start with directly with the chapter now, motion in a straight line. Distance, displacement, these will be the topics for tomorrow. Distance, displacement, average velocity, these things we'll be covering in tomorrow's class. Let us start with and complete the first chapter at least. It is a little lengthy chapter. Projectile motion is less lengthy, but this is lengthy. Anyways, the major portion is this. Please